Hello everybody, Super Jackstrone1 here. Now for this video, I'm going to be doing a review of the popular Netflix television show which became an instant hit when it premiered last month, that being 13 Reasons Why. I'm going to start by going over the plot of the show, so spoilers. This is like, you know, for anybody who hasn't seen the show yet, this is spoilers. And then I'm going to go over what I liked and what I didn't like about the show. So, if you don't know what it is, like I said, it's a Netflix show that premiered back on March 31st, 2017. It's become an instant hit, so if you haven't seen the show, by the way, please see it. Anyway, let's get started with the review, shall we? The show tells the story of a girl named Hannah Baker, who's played by Katherine Langford. She was a girl who committed suicide due to all the bad stuff that happened to her in her sophomore and junior year of high school. And she really didn't do anything about it, so because of that, she took her own life. We then meet our main character, Clay Jensen, who's played by Dylan Minnette. He was Hannah's, like, you know, pretty much best friend. They worked together at a movie theater and everything. And Clay has been trying to get over, like, her death. He is remaining kind of calm. He's been saying he didn't really know her, but really he did. He's just trying to move on with his life until when he comes home to. When he comes home from school one day, he finds a package with his... for him. He opens the package and he finds 13 cassette tapes inside and a map. When he plays the cassette tapes, he hears Hannah's voice and she's explaining, like, you know, like telling him, like, you know, to get comfortable and everything, and will explain, says she's gonna explain everything that caused her to end her life. And with using his best friend Tony's tape recorder, Clay listens to each and every one of the tapes and uses a map to go to the locations that keeps cutting the flashbacks. We learn more about the Hannah character, what caused her to commit suicide. Now, I don't really have anything bad to say about the show because the show is almost flawless. I'd only say my only complaint about the show is that I think they just went a little too graphic. Most notably the last episode. I'm not going to say what happens in the last episode because, you know, spoilers for those who haven't seen the show yet. It is pretty graphic. Luckily, they have all those warnings at the beginning, like, warning people about it. But I do think they went a little over graphic, and that's caused some controversy. But overall, aside from that, the show really doesn't have any other bad problems. Now, let's get to the positive stuff. Like I said, the show is incredible. It's probably the best Netflix show I've seen ever. The acting is good, and most notably, the actors who play Clay and Hannah, their acting is spectacular. Dylan Minnette was the perfect choice for Clay Jensen. He did it. He really, like, you know, played that role. He was born for that role. Oh, definitely, in my opinion. And Katherine Langford, incredible, perfect choice for Hannah Baker. And also, other cast members, won't say much name, but their characters of Courtney, Tyler, Bryce, Jessica, Tyler, all of them, just Alex, just etc. All of them perfect choices for all the characters. Everything, the acting is really good. It makes so realistic. Everything, it just works real perfect. And the way, like, you know, they presented the show, it looked so realistic. I always thought I was kind of watching like a reality show, kind of. The creators and executive producer Selena Gomez just really worked hard to make it, you know, kind of like book almost, kind of, because it's based on the book of the same name, but they add a lot more to it and everything. It just works out perfectly, in my opinion. It just, I don't know, the show is just, I don't know what is it that makes the show so great, but it works. I know the show has gotten some controversy over how, like, graphic it was and how, like, you know, what it encouraged a lot of students to do, but, you know, a show is a show, and sometimes shows can do that. But like I said, if it wasn't for my friend Oscar, I had no idea about the show, but my friend Oscar just told me all about the show, and, you know, I heard all about it, and I'm like, I'll check it out. And I started watching over April break. I finished the show in just 8 days. Incredible. Well, that's all I really have to say about my review for 13 Reasons Why. I hope you enjoyed this little quick review. If you haven't seen 13 Reasons Why, once again, I highly recommend it. If you've seen 13 Reasons Why, please let me know what you guys think of it. Because honestly, in my opinion, I think it's a very good show. But hey, everybody's entitled to their own opinion. But for me, I thought it was great. Just let me know how...